key takeaways from the budget now, more than two and a half hour long speech by the finance minister now?
It had to go to such a long level because the government was not in a position to be announcing anything of a big bang nature. But I would say I need to appreciate the finance minister for having thought through about what needs to be initiated for the medium to long term for the country. The first part of her speech itself is indicative of what all do we need to do in the country to ensure that the rural consumption increases. An allocation made of 2.83 lakh crores of rupees, and with the articulation done for each of the item in that area, I would appreciate her for that one. Similarly, another good thing is dividend distribution tax is withdrawn. And one more thing done is income tax slabs in that 5 lakhs to 15 lakhs in that particular slab, tweaking done. Is certainly going to be helping the people, the younger lot of people, because who will be earning between 5 to 15 lakh rupees? These are the people who have entered the industry, the initial stages, where they're still buying a home or buying white goods or maybe buying automobile. So they are all on EMI. For a chap who's paying an EMI to have $1,000 extra, $5,000 extra, which is going to be certainly helping him to ensure that, he is able to increase his consumption. So this is something which all of us had been asking for. We need consumption to go up because consumption is coming down. It's not good for a consuming economy like India. Very positive move. Now, where are we not been able to do really well? Government is already, she admitted that we borrowed 4.99 lakh or 5 lakh crores of rupees last year. But I would have preferred she not going in for one more fiscal year with a 3.8% deficit, which would have left a lot more money in the hands of the government, which would have manifested in way of a lot more of projects which would create consumption, and in commodity industries like cement, steel, all could have happened also. That is something which I think as a bold decision we should have taken for one more year.
What about your industry? Government did announce a couple of spends as well there, scheme for the DISCOM as well. How do you take that?
See, power industry per se is under distress. The entire allocation from the budget is only 22,000 crores of rupees. Whether it is for thermal power, is it for wind or renewable solar, and it is very small a sum for power industry. 22,000 crore will be just sufficient to set up one power plant. For a country of our size, that doesn't make a difference. I think it's a different subject, and I don't think she would have been able to address it over here in the power. I am also talking on behalf of the capital goods industry, of which power equipment manufacturing is one of the items only. There I would say that if the consumption were to lift up and the GDP growth were to go back to maybe 6.5% to 7%, that will help us because then the capacity utilization of customers will increase. So that will force them to go for new capacity, which will mean they'll buy more equipments. So that is something which I'm looking forward to. But another area of concern is that the government is not able to be supporting the banking industry and the NBFC. Though she mentioned casually in that one, I don't think there is any allocation done for recapitalization of banks. So in case if an NPA were to be hitting in any of the quarters coming forward, the lending will come down in the country. So all what the dreams that we're currently projecting may not come through. My take is, let's be prepared for one more tough year.
Yeah. Lot of spends announced, concern revolves around how you're going to fund those things. That's a bigger concern.
Yeah. Because you should recognize for a fact that it's the plus and minus. The current quarter, good number of banks have reported good results. But is it a quarter flash in the pan, or is it going to be consistently followed thereafterwards? If they're able to make it happen consistently, then there is money going to be available. Recapitalization may not be a necessity. But if there is going to be a distress tomorrow, do the government have money to recapitalize the bank and ensure the balance sheets are capable of lending? That worry is there. NBFC, she mentioned one particular sentence, but what are they going to do? That is one. But one positive for the industry to talk about is, at least they have started talking about for MSME, an allocation number one, and a factoring. Because fundamentally, what does MSME want? A circulation of money. They don't have the balance sheet deeper, a treasury available for funding their day-to-day affairs. They work on circulation of money. So when customers aren't paying through factoring, I don't know anybody has understood what it means. When you have a factoring done, a bank will pay for an outstanding amount from a customer and the bank will collect it from the customer. And if an MSME is not paid within 45 days, there's a criminal issue in the country. So factoring being brought into MSME is a good thing for them. So that part possibly can be articulated and done well in the future. But for the larger investments, banking system, I have my own doubts.
So I've been for a deeper slowdown now. The country has been grappling through a sentiment economy, with the auto sector as well grappling through its own set of slowdown. So with this, the kind of initiative government has announced, with no clarity how they're going to fund it, a larger impetus on, you know, revising the taxation for the personal income tax. But are we in for a tougher ride, like you mentioned? Are we in for a deeper slowdown now?
I told we should expect one more tough year. I didn't say tougher year. So we are at such a level that can only go up now. Because with all the activities going around the country, and sentiments are lower not because of economic reasons. It's non-economic political reasons is one which has created the current sentiments that's prevailing in the country for investment. A lot of people are worried about the stability. Various, I'm not talking about political stability. That is something which we took for granted maybe a few years, maybe even I would say 1 year back, that it is going to be stable, strong for longer period of time. See, there are only 100 people who take a decision in the country for larger investments. The Industrial House of India. It's not somebody new going to come. Those 100 people to feel very confident, I want to commit and I want to take any amount of loan and I can repay it tomorrow. That has got to happen slightly differently. It is more of a political issue than an economic issue. Yeah. So we are not in for anything tougher. A tough year means what we underwent last year, be prepared for it. It will only lift up there afterwards.
Right, many thanks for time and speaking to BloombergQuint, sir.